So one task that we've been putting off for almost a year now is to fix up our stone floor. So very soon after we laid all this stone back in October of last year, this area of stone, all the mortar between the stones started to crack a little bit. It was a very localized problem right in this area here, so we're thinking it was just one of our batches of mortar didn't quite have the right water content. It hasn't spread to the rest of the floor. But we've been dealing with loose rocks for almost a year now, and we figured it's finally time to fix this up. So before a hard day's work, we've gotten into the healthy habit of drinking AG1, today's sponsor. AG1 is a foundational nutrition supplement that supports whole body health. We love that AG1 gives us a good dose of magnesium and B vitamins, which sustains our energy throughout the day. It also replenishes nutrients, so AG1 contains 75 vitamins and minerals, a broad spectrum of micronutrients and phytonutrients that keep the body nourished. So when AG1 reached out to us, we were very pleased to find out that they have the highest quality ingredients and the strictest manufacturing standards. They are NSF certified for sport, which is the gold standard for professional athletes. And we like the taste. We both agree it tastes like pineapple. So thanks again to AG1 for sponsoring today's video. If you're interested, please go to drinkag1.com/nickandmyle to get started on your order. AG1 is going to give you a free 1-year supply of AG vitamin D3 plus K2 and 5 AG1 travel packs with your first purchase. So let's get back to the video. So the ladder is pretty much done. One thing that we were planning to do with it, but that didn't work out, was to use a couple of these pistons on the sides of the ladder to help us lift it up and to hold it up. But even with two of these on the sides of the ladder, it wasn't really strong enough to hold the ladder. It kind of just ended up falling down. So we're gonna leave it as is for now. It's not too hard to lift the ladder up, and it does stay up on its own, which is nice. In the future, we might think of another way, maybe with some springs or something to help lift it up. But for now, it works fine for us. It's all we really need. So we're finally getting around to doing the mortar on our last exterior wall. So you may have noticed that we're using a mesh with slightly bigger holes than the ones on the last wall that we did. And that's because we think it's going to help us really be able to push the mortar between the holes of the mesh. On the small holes, it was a little bit tough. We felt like it wasn't really getting behind the mesh and grabbing onto it. So we're going to hopefully see that this one holds the mortar together the best out of all our four walls, and if it does, then we'll just end up using this on the entire interior of the cabin. And you might have also noticed that we kept some of the rock wool insulation between the logs. We just pushed it as far in as we can get it, just to really help seal up the gaps between the logs, make sure there's no air passing between the inside and outside, and to give us a little bit more insulation.